Okay, so I already know what you're thinking. You're so excited about your podcast, but now you've hit a snag in the road. You need to record remotely and you have no idea how to make that happen. Let me show you exactly how you can record an entire podcast episode directly from your phone. Hi, I'm Crystal Prophet, and today we are going to discuss how you can record an entire podcast just from your phone. So I was recently on a trip with my family to San Antonio. It was our end of the summer trip, and I realized in order to stay on track with my content calendar and everything I had planned for my podcast, I needed to record an episode. But I use my normal Blue Yeti whenever I'm at home and I have my office set up and I'm ready to record. So I thought, I don't want to take a bunch of clunky equipment with me on vacation. If you have kids or you understand what it's like to pack for a family of five, then you know basically we took everything but the kitchen sink. So I didn't want to take anything else with us on vacation that wasn't necessary. So what did I have available? I had my phone and some earbuds, and that's actually all you need. You need an iPhone and earbuds and the Voice Memos app, which already comes standard on your phone, in order to do exactly what we're talking about today. So let me show you how to do this. So I'm going to show you exactly on my phone everything that I'm doing. So check out right here and follow along with this entire process. So I'm going to go to my Voice Memos app, which, like I said earlier, comes standard on most iPhones and iPads, any of the Apple products. And it is as simple as opening up the Voice Memos and hitting record. Look, guys, you can actually see the bouncy lines are going as I'm talking. And this is as simple as all you have to do to record your podcast. Now, I don't recommend just speaking directly into the phone because there could be background noises, there could be something else going on. So I want you to grab your earbuds that have the built-in microphone, and then I want you to record this way. So I'm gonna do this again. I'm gonna hit record, and as you can see, it is bouncing up and down once again, but the actual, the audio is gonna be a lot crisper whenever you have the microphone, like, what, it's closer to your mouth. So it's not gonna sound all distorted or anything like that. It's gonna sound like a higher quality sound. And that's what we want for our podcast, even if we're recording remotely. And then from there, as you can see, it just defaults to wherever you are. It actually just takes the location of the Wi-Fi that you're connected to. When I was in San Antonio, it actually had like the actual resort name on here, but I'm just going to click where it says home 5, and I'm going to change it to demo episode. You can name it whatever you need to for your podcast. And then that's as simple as that. Like, that's all you can do. You can hit play, and then actually we'll play back. And then I'm gonna hit this ellipses button right here, and that is gonna allow me to edit the recording. So I can click edit recording. So if you need to actually, you know, if there was background noises, or if there was, you know, somebody came up to you, or there was, you know, something crazy and loud happened, if you're in a hotel lobby, then you can edit right here within the episode before you ever even upload it to your computer or anywhere else if you wanted to further edit in Audacity or something. So I'm happy with this because this is the demo. So I'm gonna click done, and then I'm gonna go back and hit the ellipses button, and then I'm gonna share it with myself because I like to add my music, and I have a main podcast theme, and I have my self-sponsored ads. So I love to add those to all of my podcast episodes. So I'm actually going to send this, I'm going to put this into my Google Drive because that is where I like to put everything, and it's going straight to my drive. So I'm gonna click upload, and it's good to go. So now that I've showed you how to record it on your phone, we're gonna hop on over to my computer, and I'm gonna show you exactly how you can extract these files and get them ready for editing in whatever editing software you're using for your podcast. But before we jump over to the laptop, I want you to comment below if you use any certain apps to talk between your phone and your computer. I prefer to use Google Drive. I know a lot of people like Dropbox. So share in the comments below if there is another app that you like to use, or if your mind is just blown that you can switch in between your phone and your laptop or your desktop or whatever you're working on, because this is such a hack for me to be able to share files while I'm on the go, or if I think of something really quickly, then I will upload it into my Google Drive, and it is such a time saver for me. So let's get on over to the laptop and let me show you exactly what I do after I have recorded an episode on my phone. Okay, so now we are in my Google Drive, and as you can see, the demo episode that we just uploaded is actually an M4A file. What does that mean? That means that if you use a software like Audacity to edit your podcast, Audacity will not recognize this type of file. So if you record something on your phone, you're like, oh great, I have this to use. Well, it actually won't You can't actually upload it directly into Audacity without one very important process. And if you've seen my other Audacity editing videos, you see how I use Cloud Convert to convert files over so Audacity will read them. So if you haven't checked those out, be sure to watch those videos. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna right click on this one and click download. So it's gonna give me the file, and then I can actually take it, and I have Cloud Convert opened right here. I can take this file and literally just drag it and drop it into Cloud Convert. And then it says it is ready to go. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna convert this file from what it is, the M4A, to an MP3. That way Audacity is happy with it. It is what it likes to see. You could do an MP3 or a WAV file. That's another option that Audacity will recognize that, but I just choose to go with the MP3. It's what I always work with. And then I click start conversion. So it'll take a little while depending on how long your audio is. Since this was just a test and it was a few seconds, it didn't take very long. But if you recorded an entire hour long episode on your phone, it could take a while for this process to happen. Okay, so now all I have to do is click download, and boom, I have an MP3 ready to go and be uploaded in Audacity or whatever other podcast software I'm using. And that's it. That's all you need to do to record an entire podcast right on your phone, right? It's pretty simple. I loved having this option whenever we were traveling on vacation because it just made my life so much easier, and the sound quality was awesome. I think it would have been better had I not been in a really busy hotel lobby, but you know, I like to experiment with these things. So I would love for you to comment below if you have any other questions about remotely recording podcasts, because I plan on doing a lot more experiments just like this in the future to help y'all out. And this is just so much fun for me. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. I encourage you to hit the subscribe button. That way you can see all the other amazing podcast videos that we have that come out every Friday. And if you're just getting started with your podcast, I invite you to our free 5-day podcast bootcamp, where you're going to learn everything you need to know to start, launch, and market your podcast. So I will see y'all in the next video. Remember, keep it up. We all have to start somewhere. Be sure to check out these other amazing videos that we have. They're all about podcasting. It's because I'm planning on doing a lot more experience. Because I plan on doing a lot more experience.